I listen to this song. Mwambie Bwana asante, jina lako limetukuka katika maisha yangu, katika nyumba yangu, katika jamii yangu na kila mahali Bwana napopitia. Naomba Bwana unisaidie. Asante Mtakatifu, maana umetusaidia na jina lako limebarikiwa, limeinuliwa mno. Wewe ni Mungu mkuu, Mungu mwenye uwezo, Mungu mwenye mamlaka, Mungu ambaye Baba umetenda mengi, umetenda maajabu. Katika jina la Yesu tunakupenda na kushukuru, tunasema ni asante. Umetukuka sana Yesu na umeinuliwa, maana hakuna mwingine aliye kama wewe. katika jina la Yesu tumeomba na kushukuru tuseme amen. Pigeni Bwana makofi mazuri. Amen. Naomba tukae kwa uwepo wa Bwana. Let's stand with me in the book of Exodus chapter number 224. I am talking to you again about the grace versus covenant. Tell your neighbor grace versus covenant. Please speak to me loudly. Say my grace versus covenant. Please speak to me loudly and say grace versus covenant. I'm talking to you about what I've started for the last 2 weeks about grace versus covenant. And I did say grace is an opportunity that the Lord gives you or anybody gives you that you don't deserve it. So it means that you must work hard to sustain and maintain grace. Do you understand what I'm saying? It is an opportunity that you are given by God or by man, for that extension, by man, that you don't deserve it, but you are adopted in the same. Romans chapter number 9 verse 15, the Bible says, I show mercy to whom I see, that the one I choose, I show mercy. That means there's something that happened. That Romans chapter number 9 verse 15, King, quickly. Romans. Now listen to this. There's one thing that I love with what we call, the Bible says, for it says, Romans 9, Thomas, I have mercy in whom I'll have mercy. In other words, I choose whom to favor. Banas was on. I choose whom to show grace. Because the word mercy, the word grace, favor, both of them are the same words. It says, I show grace or mercy or favor to whom I deserve, I desire. So necessarily, that grace is that singlest opportunity that you are given by God that you don't deserve. The Bible says the Gentiles were not qualified for salvation. But because of grace, we were all saved. Paul says, we are saved by the grace of God. What does your son? Praise the Lord. We are saved by the grace. There's an opportunity we are given that we don't deserve. Now, there's a second then we call about a covenant. Now, Exodus chapter 224. This is what God the Bible says. Covenant is a special spiritual agreement that is for everlasting. It has no time span. It has no area. It has no period of time. It can happen anytime. You can be this. That's why there are people today, you may see them poorer today, but after a short time, because of the covenant, the same people become rich. Do you understand what I'm saying? I said, you get what I'm saying? Now the Bible says God heard the groaning and God remembered his covenant. His covenant he heard, it was between Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And God remembered a covenant. Covenant are not overlooked. Covenant, no matter how long it takes, it doesn't matter how many years. Covenant is an established agreement for eternity. It is an agreement for eternity. So, grace is good, but covenant is better. When you are under grace, for example, when a husband and a wife, they don't live by grace, they live by covenant. Is it true? I say, is it true? Husband and the wife don't live by grace. They live by what? I say, by what? So there's no time you say, my wife is becoming too old. Do what? Oh, my husband is becoming too weak. He looks very old. Because when I was doing my wedding, the time I was getting married in the year 2005, March on 5th, I was not the same way I am. Is it true? Hey, my wife was hapa. Was that the same way I was? What else? I was bigger than the way I am. I was small. No, I was big. I thought I was very big. She was in my wedding. She's my only sister who came to my wedding. So the time I got married and the time I am now,
If we were looking at the qualities, for example, my wife looks and says, this guy, I married a slender, nice guy who had all the hair in the head. Now the guy hair has disappeared. He's becoming pimpy, he's too big. So the grace can be lifted. Is it true? But covenant, even when things changes, you keep on staying around. I say, even when things keep on changing, you remain around. You don't remain because of because neema inaishanga, si kweli? Si neema inaishanga? Unajua ukipendelea mtu umbebe, ukisikia mume anaambia mke wake, unajua wewe nilikuoa kwa neema, ujue kwamba run like an antelope because you are there by grace. When the grace ya mtu ikisha kwa mtu, is it true? Neema ikisha, mtu anaondokaga, si kweli? But by covenant, you have no choice. Even when the other partner becomes a cripple, even the other partner becomes sick, even the other partner is not the way you were expected. Nasikia wasungu ndio wanakuwa na hiyo tabia. Mama ukizeeka sana kama vile ndubi na mzee, unaangalia ndubi na mzee, I married you when you are very fast. Now Alex, I'm not carrying you faster. Can you disappear from me? My grace is over. Is what? Ama ujaisikia watu wasema hiyo? My grace is what? But covenant never changes. Circumstances can change, but covenant will never change. And I pray that God, who entered a covenant with his people, you can be poorer today, but when God remembers his covenant, you can come back again to be rich. I say you can come back to be rich again. I say covenant is a restoration ability that God does even when things are not working out. God can make them to work out. He says, and so God heard their groaning. They went to captivity and they stayed there for 400 years. How many years? How many years? 400 years. When they stayed in captivity for 400 years, the Bible says, and God said, he remembered his covenant that he entered. There's a covenant your parents entered. There's a covenant your husband and wife entered. There's a covenant that God has. But let me tell you, your children are not your kids by grace. They are your children by covenant. Hey, nasema watoto wako sio wako kwa neema, ni wako kwa agano. Is it true? Anasema kweli? Watoto wako sio wako kwa neema, ni wako kwa agano. Ninasema kweli? Am I speaking to somebody here? Am I speaking to somebody here? Ndio maandiko nasema in the book of Luke chapter number 15 verses 11-32. Biblia inaongea juu ya the prodigal son. The prodigal son, maandiko nasema, alisema kwa nyumba ya baba yangu kuna kila aina ya wafanyikazi. Staffs, your workers can stay with you as long as you have their grace. Is it true? I say, is it true? Now, the prodigal son said, in my father's house, there's a lot of food. There's a lot of stuff. I can go back to my father's house and I become one of his servants. Why? Because if you are servant, if you lose grace with your servant, what happens? Nasema ukipoteza neema na mfanyikazi wako. Farao alipokashirika na mwokaji, anaitwa mwokaji Kiswahili. Alipokashirika na wao mwokaji na kabera wake. What happened? He threw them to where? I said to where? Now, your servants and your friends, you are keeping them around by grace. Their thing, their condition, if they don't fulfill, when they don't fulfill it, you can lift your grace. Is it true? I say, is it true? A prodigal son said that in my father's house, there are so many staff. There are so many servants. I can go back and become one of what? One of the servants. One of what? I say, one of the what? I can go back to my father's house and become one of the servants. But the Bible says when he made up his mind, when he arrived in his father's house, he said, my father, I am not worthy to be your son. Why? But this guy is worthy to be a son by covenant.
I say he's worthy to be a son by covenant. I say this guy is worthy to be a son by this man by covenant. King is not my son by grace. He's my son by covenant. Aye. My wife is not, yani leo hii nianze kumwambia naona hii nywele zilikupa kuoa haikuwa na makonge vizuri. Naona siku hizi hujui kuweka makonge. Neema imefanya nini? Neema imepungua. Neema imefanya nini? I said, Neema, that's why you see even prostitute can work very hard. Why? Because they are there, the man is there with by grace. By what? He must do everything. He must do. Now, I will give you the 7 conditions that will sustain grace. But covenant has only 3 things. One, they must be a continuous altar that be active. Number 2, they must be a sacrifice. Number 3, there must be a priest that standeth on that altar every day. Because a covenant, it is an eternity establishment between humanity and divinity. Listen to this, my friends. It is by covenant that God has chosen us. Not because we are better. Not because what? Why do you think the Jews all over the world, they are the most richest, the most intelligent, the most powerful people? Kwanini? Now read your story. Kwanini Wayahudi ndubi, dunia muzima, ndio matajiri saidi. The billionaires of this world, who are they? The most technological characters in the whole world, who are they? I say, who are they? Are they many numbers? I say, they many numbers? What? In Deuteronomy chapter number 7, verse number 7, the Bible says, I did not choose you because you are many. You are what? I did not choose you because you are many. But by covenant, I choose you because I loved you. Because when you love, number one, when you are in the covenant, whether you like it or not, unanielewa? Mama Christian, kuna siku utamea umbue. Unanielewa? Na wewe bwana wako anaanza kuvaa miwani kama side mirror, goggles. Yaani mmezeeka mnatembea hivi, unanielewa? Mnaanza kutiana moyo. Wewe kuja. And you can have patience to wait because it's covenant. But grace, somebody gets let you go away. Ama? Mtu mwenye unasaidia akuja amechelewa utamuoja hapo. Nauliza swali please. May microphone. You don't faith. Kuna siku unajitangaza mimi ni me so bad kwa barabara. Do you announce yourself? Ukimkuta akiongea na anybody on the road, tena unamwambia we mwanaume tukutane nyumbani na ulitoa, yani ukitaka kutuma message ya kutosha na ile nguo niliweka kwa kitanda ulitoa, yani unataka kutuma kwa wale ambao wana survive kwa neema ya ajue kwamba wewe uko mpaka ndani kwa kitanda, sio mezani. Wa neema nakaa hapo nje, si ni kweli? Tell your neighbor, grace is better but covenant is extra better. You never talk to him and say, grace is good, but covenant is excellent. Please talk to someone and say, covenant is excellent. That's why unaonaga mtu amezaa mtoto kiwete. Hata kama mtu amezaa mtoto kiwete, hana mguu ama ana macho ana meno ama nini, anampenda, anamnyonyesha. Ananyonyesha wa jirani? Nauliza, ananyonyesha wa jirani? Ananyonyesha wa jirani? Hata wajiani akwe mzuri, akwe msmati, amesimama, you are not moved. Unapenda mtu dakika kidogo and then unamwambia hey nimechoka na wewe. That's why women, by the time that you are chosen by grace, you are chosen by what? It is your effort to enter a covenant with a man that will never break. Do you know that? I said, do you know that? Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Barisheba alichukuliwa kwa neema tu. Alichukuliwa kwa neema, akaonekana akawa anaoga bure, huyo mwanamume akapenda akagalasi. Huyu mwanamke akajua kwamba huyo hiyo kinyangaleka nitamcatch mahali. Akashika huyo mzee akamwambia, the Bible says alishika David, wakati David at the covenant of his peak, akamwambia mzee, wewe vile unakuwa unakaa hivi, wewe ni mfalme. Na hebu hapa saa zile mzee on top of the game, anamwambia hebu toa agano, mtoto wangu ndiye atatawala. Mzee akiwa amechanganywa, mtoto wako mama ndiye atakuwa kiongozi. Na huyu ni mwanamke wa mpango wa kando. Barisheba alikuwa mwana wa mpango wa kando. Akamwambia Daud, "Please, my son." And this woman, no dowry paid, nothing.
even after God rejected, the Bible says, and God rejected man, saying, Solomon, I could have killed you, but when I remember the covenant I entered with your father David, 1 Kings chapter 11:11, he said, the covenant I have with your father David, I could have destroyed you today, but when I remember covenant, I will keep you for two nations for you, but the rest I will tear them out. And I pray that every covenant God has entered with you, it shall never be broken by any circumstances. Any problem you are going through today, God is a covenant remember. He will remember every covenant he entered with you. No matter what is happening around your life, no matter what is happening around your family, but when God remembers covenant, he restores you. I say we restore you. I say we restore you. After 400 years, they were in captivity. But the Bible says, and God remembered what? I say God remembered what? That is, the Bible says, and therefore the Lord said to Solomon, because you have done this, in other words, you have messed me up. If it was grace, it was what? Siangiachana naye kabisa. Siangiachana naye kabisa. Akasema, and because you have done this and have not kept my covenant, you are going to what? Not my grace, my what? And you have, which I commanded you, I will surely tear down the kingdom away from you and give it to your servant. Next verse, King, quickly. And I say, my, listen to this. And he says, nevertheless, I will not do it in your days for the sake of what? I say for the what? I say for the sake of what? Now, whatever you are doing today, you enter a covenant with God. And this covenant, even when your children mess up, God remembers his covenants. I say God remembers his covenants. I say no matter what is happening around your life, that's why the wise parents, they always invest through their children. Is it true? Deuteronomy chapter number 8 verse 16 up to 17, 18. Listen, verse 18. Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 18. In a semi, and God speaks to the children of Israel. He speaks like this and say, and he say, and you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is who gives you power to get wealth. He was telling the children of Israel that he may establish his covenant, he swear to you. I said to you, what? If you are a father, you are a parent in this house, lift up your hand like you and say, Lord Jesus. Say, my Lord Jesus, remember your covenant over my children, over my family, even the difficult time, even the economical time. God, remember your covenant. Tell my Lord, remember your covenant. Tell my, remember your covenant. There may not be a job in this country, but when God remembers his covenant, he will raise you to get a job. Amen. I told you that the other day, I told you one thing. Uhuru Kenyatta is the president of this Republic of Kenya by covenant, not by grace. By what? I said by what? By I don't campaign for him, but I must say, things will happen in any way. He will even be elected, not because he likes it, but because establishment of the covenant. Establishment what? Covenants, Mzendubi, they are not broken. Whether you try it, no matter what you do, faith. That's why Christianity, we. If you want, let me tell you, when God remembers his covenant, no matter where you are, no matter where you are located, the covenant will locate you where you are. I said the covenant will establish you where you are. No matter what you are going through, when God remembers his covenant, even want to destroy, but when he remembers the covenant, he will spare you. I say he will spare you. I say he will spare you. Even your business, if you enter a covenant you did with God, even when business are destroyed, when God remembers a covenant, he will establish and retain your business. Because kuna wakati mtu anaangalia neema anauliza, what is your grace? Bwana asiwe sana. Msichana mwenye hajaolewa unaona anafanya kila aina ya vituko, si kweli? Ndio apate neema ama inaendaga aje? Mama Christian, ukiamka asubuhi hata umevaa rapa kwa kichwa. What do you call rapa? Unakaa kama ninja. That's your husband anako. Unaamka asubuhi, umefunga hiyo unakaa kama ninja. Your husband changed his mind? Will he change his mind? But if he was not, amekuita na hajakuoa, amekupatia date. Niambie mwana, what do you do? Tell me the truth, my sister. Sikwile
Joseph alikuwa anakuitaga muonane mukunywe chawe chai kericho. Wewe upate neema na yeye na yeye apate neema na wewe. What do you do? Si unajipodoa, unatembea kwa kio kila saa. Bako unajisalimu utasema yes. Ah no. Na yeye ndi apate neema na wewe anajiami hata afadhali akopeshe nilango anambie emergency emergency brother give me 1,000 I'll give you 9 now. Why? Because you want grace. You want what? When you get somebody by grace, you work hard to establish a covenant. I say you work hard to establish a covenant. Listen to this. The Gibeonites chapter number 9. Joshua. The Gibeonites walimpata Joshua, alikuwa na njaa. Wakamwambia Joshua, tumekuletea chakula na tulisikia vile Mungu amekutunza. Akapata neema na wao. Akawaeleza akamwambia, please Joshua, usitukashike sisi, tulitoka mbali, sisi ni watu wa nguvu. Kule nyuma kuna chakula tumekuletea ya nguvu sana. Hata zile punda unaona ni chakula zimebeba. Joshua akapata neema na wao, akamwambia come. Akasema, brother, kabla mchakula, wacha tuingie agano kwanza. Hebu hapa na useme ya kwamba kuanzia leo tafadhali hata tukikaa katika chenu usituue, sisi tutakata kuni, tutachota maji na tutawapikia. Joshua akasema, my friend, mpata neema na mimi, kuanzia leo nyinyi ni wetu. Wewe na mimi na nyinyi ni wetu. Hatutavunja ile agano. Utakuwa pamoja sisi. By the time Joshua was coming to his senses, akakuta kwamba these people were tricking him. They were just neighbors. Tell your neighbor they were neighbors. Hai, mwambie mwenzako they were neighbors. Walikuwa just across. Listen to this. Asema, it came to pass the king was on the other side. Hebu ena verse number king. Chapter number 9, ena verse number 23. Ndiyo tumelizia hapo kwa sababu ni haraka. Listen to this. Joshua cast them. Enda, under 20, under 20, 20, 20, 20, 20. 20, 20, 20, 20, verse number 20. I have to give it. Then they will do to them, they will not let them live. Let's wrath upon because